TV. Thanks for tuning in, and today I'll be introducing to you the Madball Powder Shot O2, and also showing you how to strip it apart and do your regular maintenance. Various skirmish sites in the past have banned the use of Dynatech style BFG grenades due to its hard shell, loud output, or maybe even using percussion caps for their blank firing grenades. Although a few of these reasons may also affect the use of cold burning pyrotechnic grenades or other airsoft grenades, Madball have decided to produce a training grenade which does not produce too high of an output power, even if used in a confined area. Using propane as a choice of gas, this also means the expansion ratio compared to CO2 is much lower, almost by a third. With propane being the choice of gas for this grenade, this is very convenient if your gas guns are already in propane and not 134A. If you were to use CO2 for this, well, it may not last. From using the same construction method as the Madball stun grenade, which we previously have used in the video, you would know this type of construction is very, very solid, and you would not have to worry about damaging the grenade in any way, just a normal throw. If you do need to take this apart for any maintenance, or check to see if you need to replace any O-rings, this is relatively tool-free. All you will need is an Allen key. But before you do that, you need to check the grenade there's no gas in it. Using an Allen key, push down on the fill valve until you see it depressed. If you do not see or hear any gases escaping, this means your grenade is ready to take apart and is safe. Now that your grenade is ready to take apart, pull out the safety pin and release the spoon. You will see on the spoon head there is a grub screw. Use the Allen key and unscrew that. You do not need to take the grub screw out completely, just loose enough so that it releases the spoon head from the main shaft. Unscrew the spoon head as shown, and then push out the main body. Now that you have your gas reservoir and delay mechanism out, you will see towards the top there is a moving rod. Once the grenade is charged, the gas pressure will force the rod to move up and will detonate once it reaches the top here. But for now, I will show you how to adjust the fuse timing, fast and stress-free. Reset your delay mechanism by pushing the moving rod back down and charge the grenade whilst having your thumb holding the top here. Let go of the delay plunger and see how long this takes to detonate. That was maybe 2 seconds, it may be a little too short. To lengthen the fuse timing, screw this tighter whilst holding the bottom half, as shown here. This delay mechanism is very sensitive, you only need to adjust a small fraction of a turn. To test the fuse timing again, push the moving rod down and recharge. Release the moving rod to test your fuse timing again. That was about 5 seconds. Slightly longer than my liking, but it will do for now. For maintenance, this is also extremely easy to do, and does not require any further tools. Make sure there's no gas charge in the grenade, and unscrew the gas cap at the bottom here. Next, push down the delay mechanism all the way down the shaft. This is the delay mechanism. Next, you will need some silicone. Spray a little bit on the O-rings, as shown here. See the little hole here? This is where the moving shaft goes down. Spray some silicone down there, make sure that all the moving parts are lubricated. Remember, if you do not have any silicone oil, do not use any petroleum or mineral-based oils, as this will corrode your O-rings over time. Because previously, people have questioned the output level of the Powder Shot O2 grenade since it uses propane instead of CO2. We have a dB meter here, which will record the highest maximum output of this grenade in decibels. Let's see how many dBs this gives.
Fucking hell.
Now that you've lubricated your grenade and set your fuse timing, all you need to do is wait for your next game. Happy fragging and stay safe. You've been watching Red Wolf TV. My name is Shinji Yamamoto. See you next time. For these products and more, please visit www.redwolfairsoft.com.